פרק שישי, page 28, quotation from our Torah, book of Vayikra, chapter 22, verse 22, translation, blind or broken, or maimed or having a wen, or scrub, all these different defects, you shall not offer these to God, nor make an offering by fire upon them, the altar. The same you see, just change the words in Dvarim, in Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 10. So basically, we are about to deal with chapter called Kol HaIsurim, with situations where a defect in the animal causes to be entirely disqualified from being consecrated as an offering. Kol HaAsurim Legabei Mizbeach, all animals whose offer on the altar is prohibited, but it's not psul nikar, it's not clear, osrim bechol shehen, so they prohibit the entire mixture of animal in any amount, regardless of the ratio of permitted to prohibited animals. Now, the Mishnah give us the list of those animals that en psulam nikar, that you don't recognize it. Harovea vehanirba, any type of object of bestiality, either from the animal or from a person. Later, we expand on that. Vehamukze, it was an animal that set aside for idol worshipping. Vehane evad, later we expand on that, something that they was already idol worshipped. Veha'etnan, etnan is the payment that was set to be given to a prostitute. Veha'u mechir, so imagine Reuven and Shimon inherited from their father, late father, 20 animals, was 19 sheep and one dog. So they divided it. Reuven get 10, let's say 10 goats, 10 sheep, and Shimon get 9 plus one dog. So 1 for 1. So number 10, it's Michir Kelev. Veha Kil'aim. Kil'aim is the mixture of diverse kind, meaning animal that was born from that breeding of such as goat and sheep or things like that. Vehatreifa, we explained several times that applies to any blemishes in an animal that's going to cause the death of the animal in the framework of 12 months. Veyotze dofen, an animal that was born by C-cesarean section. Ezeu mukze, now we're going zoom into two, mukze and evad. What is mukze? What is the animal that it set aside? Hamukze la'avodat kochavim. Someone who designated the animal for idol worship, but he yet did not idol worship that animal. Rashi on Zvachim 27b, expand on that. You see it also in Tosfot in Avodah Zarah 22b. But it's basically arrived, and others said that it was a designation for idol worshipper. Hu asu umashe alav mutar. So the animal itself is prohibited, but that which is upon it, which is the jewelry and garment, is permitted to be sold in order to purchase an animal to be sacrificed. Ve'ezehu hane'evad, and what? Which is the animal that was a worship, kolsho of dimoto, any type that the owner worshipped. You see it unfortunately in Tibet, in India nowadays. the people who worship the animal as God, who umashe alav asur, so the animal itself, an animal purchase using the money from the sale of that which is upon it is prohibited, and the consumption of both ומה שעליו עשו, הוא מה שעליו עשו, וזה וזהו, consumption of both, this and the animal designated for idol worship, זה וזה וזה, regardless if it's מוקצה או נאבד, מותר באכילה אדיוט, they allowed to eat it. The animal worship is permitted to be consumed. Later the Gemara expands on that on page 29, especially the treifa, that you cannot use anything only to drive benefit. But let's go to the Gemara. Amar mar osrin bechol shehem. In the Mishnah we learn kol ha'asurim negabei mizbeach, all the animals whose sacrifice on the altar is prohibited, that if they are intermingled with animal whose sacrifice is permitted. So the Shita Mekubetzet Ed Maika Mashmelan, what do you derive from that? The Lobatlei Beruba. That those animals that are disqualified for the Mizbeach, for the altar, they're not, are not nullified by a majority. So this is difficult. Because we learn in the Mishnah, in Maseches Zvachim, page 70b, Tanina, Kol HaKodashim Shenitarvu Bechaotarot Meitot. So, that's the Halacha LeMoshe Mesina that we learn in Zvachim. And we learn earlier, if you remember, on page 21, all the five type of the sacrificial animal that were intermingled with an animal from which deriving benefit is prohibited, which is sin offering, or b'shor haniskal. So if a person, if they're intermingled with the ox that already sentenced to be stoned, meaning you have an ox that first time gore a person and it's tam, and then second, third time it's already, it's mu'ad and it's nidon l'skila, as we learned several times in Bava Kamma 41. So afilu echad beribo yamutu. He said, even if the ratio is 1 in 10,000, driving benefit from them all is prohibited. It's all prohibited and they must all die. Vekashi alam, and we have a difficulty in this Mishnah. Maikama, what exactly the Tana meant to say when he hold afilu echad beribo, even 1 of 10,000? Which means the word even in the phrase, even 1 of the 10,000 was difficult for us. What exactly is he saying? Because you have a clear indication by using that word that the novelty of the Mishnah's ruling is that even if one permitted animal was intermingled with 10,000 prohibited animals, they are all prohibited. On the other hand, this is less of a novelty than in the reverse case, since if in a situation when the minority of prohibited items become, they are intermingled with a majority of permitted animal, they are all prohibited. So how all the more so, kal vachomer, when the prohibited items are the majority. So they said, hachi katani, that's what we learn, all kol hazvachim she'aksherim nitarvu bahem mechataot hametot. O shoran iskal, afilu beribu yamutu. They said, all that the animals that are fit for the altar, if there were intermingled with them an animal from which deriving benefit is prohibited, which means one of the five sin offering that are left to die, if they are rendered disqualified, or if they were intermingled with an ox that is sentenced to be stoned, so even afilu beribo yamutu, even if one prohibited animal was intermingled in 10,000 permitted animals, So driving benefit from them is prohibited, and they must all die. So what do we derive from that? The halacha that we learn in the Mishnah here was already taught in Masechet Zvachim. So why you need to repeat it here again? Itzrich, we need it. Salkada ata chamina hatam. Over there, when it's come to chataot metot and the ox shoa niskal, hu de isurei ana'a. Over there, it's talk about the items from which driving benefit is prohibited. Aval hacha, here in our Mishnah, de lav isure ana'a eima livtil beruba. So here is Rashi, Arichut Barashi. Rashi used also the word klomar. כלומר, ממין אותו קורבן שנתערב בהם משלמים, היו יביא בדמי יפה שבהם משלמים. The הקדש לנינה is occupied with the whole idea of the הקדש will not get in the הפסד. Anyway, there's a question if they're stoning the ox is a knas or not knas in the forshim. Anyway, kamash melan, so it's come to teach us that even animals that are merely prohibited to be sacrificed, prohibit other animals in any amount. ורובה ונירבה נמי תנינה, we also learn over there in Mishnah in Zvachim 71, נתערבו רובה ונירבה, if the רובה and נירבה, those animals that have involvement with bestiality, either they did or someone did to them, and they mix with other animals that kosher, יראו עד שיסתעבו, you leave the animals to graze until develop a blemish, and then you can redeem them, וימחרו, and then you sell it for a non-sacred. ויביא בדמי יפה שבהם אותו אמין. So you take that money and you bring in that monetary value of the higher quality animal among them from the same species as the offering with which they were intermingled. So you see here a clear indication that even in the case of an animal that may not be sacrificed, but from which one may derive benefit, it nevertheless renders other animal prohibited when intermingled. Omar Rav Kahana, so Rav Kahana responded and said, Amrita leshmata kamei de Rav Shimi Barashi. So he said, I repeat this shmua, this statement before the great Rav Shimi Barashi. Amar li, he responded and he said to me, Chada bechulin. So he said that they one Mishnah, our Mishnah, they speaks about their mixture where they are still non-sacred, and the owner subsequently consecrated them. V'chada b'kodashim, and the other Mishnah in Zvachim is referring to a situation where they become intermingled when they are already consecrated. That's basically based on the beginning of the Mishnah that said in Zevachim, page 70b, all the offering which indicates that there are already offerings. Utzrichei, and we need both Mishnayot, is both of them unnecessary. Dei ashmunan gabei kodashim, mishum demeisei, because it's ma'us to gavah, because they are repulsive, which means when the sacrifice element began to mingle with the other animals, they were immediately disqualified from being sacrificed on the altar. Aval gabei chulin, but with regard to animals that became intermingled when they were still non-sacred, at which stage they are not considered repulsive to the altar, as the altar does not yet have a claim to them, one may say, eima livtilei. Let them be nullified in the mixture after the Mishnah here teaches that even if the animals become intermingled when they are non-sacred, nevertheless the entire mixture is prohibited. Ubechulin, the Gemara continued to ask, but also we learned the halacha that the entire mixture is prohibited with regard to non-sacred items in another Mishnah, in Tractate Avodah Zarah, page 74. ובחולין נמי תנינה, ואילו הן, ואילו אסורים ואוסרים בכל שהן. So here we talk about תערובת. These are the items that are prohibited in themselves, and that deem other items prohibited, if they become intermingled with them in any amount. יין עשך, wine used for libation in idol worship, ועבודת כוכבים, and an object for idol worship, וציפורי מצורע, ציפורי מצורע, so this is the leper, the Torah said in Vayikra, chapter 14, and you see it also at the Negaim 14, they said that those birds that with a tear opposite the heart, a sign, ve'orot levuvim, a sign of the practice of sacrificing hearts of live animals for idol worship. So that's the Rabbeinu Nisim expand on that. That's part of the idol worshiping they used to do at Rashi in Avodah Zarah 32, expand also how they did. ושיער נזיר, the shave of hair of a Nazirite, that's in the book of Bamidbar, Numbers chapter 6, verse 18. ופטר חמור, and the firstborn donkey in Exodus 13:13. ובשר בחלב, that's a well-known concept that we learn in Chulin 1:16, based on the Torah that lo tevashel, and we learn also in Chulin 1:13. mixture veshor haniskal, as we discussed, ve'egla arufa, the heifer whose neck is broken, ve'chulin shenishchatu ba'azara, and some said it's parentheses, different girsaot, but ve'sair ha'mishtaleach, one la'azazel, one yom kippur, harei elu asurin ve'osrin bechol shehen. So they are prohibited in themselves, and they deem mixture prohibited in any amounts. Here is a Rashi in Tarovet de'chulin that said, klomar, we don't have time. צריכה. So the Gemara said, answers that both Mishnayot are necessary. Diyash Muinan Hatam, parentheses, Diyisura Na'ad Elo Batlei, Avalach Alib Telei, Viyash Muinan Ha'achad Ele Gavua. The Ma'is, the only reason, because it's the repulsive, Aval Elehei Diyotei Ma'isura Na'ali Batlu Beruba. Kamash Melan. So therefore, they come and teaches us, the Mishnah in Avodah Zarah, that this that even items not designated for use upon the altar render other items prohibited and are not nullified by a majority. There is Rabbeinu Gershom and Rashi, they have a different girsaot here. And the whole chiddush is that if it's mixture, it's not batel berov. Anyway, ורובי אבניר בא מנהלן דאסיר לגבוה. From where do we know that animal that capitulated with a person and the animal that was the object of bestiality, that is the disqualified animals, the תנור הבנן. The Torah said, beginning of Vayikra, chapter 1, verse 2, מן הבהמה, מן הבהמה, meaning, you derive from that, from the cattle, להוציא רובה ונרבה, to exclude an animal that capitulated with a person, an animal that was an object of bestiality from eligibility of an offering. So the Gemara asks, ולודינו, you can derive it from קל וחומר, ומה בעלמום שלא נתעבדה בו עבירה פסול לגבי מזבח, if animals that carries a blemish, that not committed any sin, is already disqualified to serve on the altar. רובה ונרבה שנעבדה בהם עבירה, אין עודין שיהיה אסורים לגבי מזבח, those animals that involve bestiality, how much so, קל וחומר. אז אם הוא עושה את חורש, בשור וחמור יוכיח, the case of one who violates the prohibition of plowing with an ox and donkey together, which is Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 10, shall prove that the above claim is invalid. שנתאבדה בו עבירה, הוא מותר לגבי מזבח. But it was a transgression, was committed with the ox, and yet it is permitted to sacrifice it upon the altar. So the Gemara reject that, and said, מה לחורש בשור וחמור של חייב ומיטה? תאמר ברובה ונרבה שחייב ומיטה. So the Gemara said, "Tol lach ma sheheveta." Retract from that which you cited as a refutation of the this kal vachomer. And Rashi here said, "Arei shenidabda avera b'shnei edim." כלומר, הרי יש לך להביא בדין אותו ששני עדים מעידים בו שרבה או שנרבד, הוא ודאי חייב מיטה ואסור לגבוה. נעבדה עבירה, עבירה על פי עד אחד או על פי בעלים מניין. אמר רבי שמעון, אני דן, ומה בעל מומשן התראה בשני עדים פוסלתו מאכילה, הודעת עד אחד פוסלתו מהקרבה. ברובה ונרבה שהודעת שני עדים פוסלתו מאכילה, אין עוד דין שהודעת עד אחד פוסלתו מהקרבה. תלמוד לומר, so therefore the verse state, מן הבהמה, from the cattle, להוציא, to exclude, רובה ונרבה, an animal that captured with a person, an animal that was an object of bestiality from eligibility as offering. So the Gemara asks, however, והעתיה מדינה, they said that this halakha was just inferred through the kal vachomer inference by Rab Shimon. So the Gemara explained that the fact the halakha of an animal that captured with a person and an animal that was an object to of bestiality cannot be inferred by a kal vachomer inference according to the sages who disagree with Rab Shimon. Page 28b, אמר רב אשי משום דייקה למימר, מעיקרה דדינה פרחה, because we consider a refutation of the קל וחומר inference is found in the basic of the case itself, which means there is a problem with the comparison. מה לבעל מום שכן מומו ניכר, when it speak about blemish, is something that is conspicuous, and it should perhaps be disqualified for this reason. תאמר ברובה ונרווה שאין מומו ניכר, you don't know it. הואיל ואין מומו ניכר יהיה קשר לגבי מזבח, since you don't recognize the blemish, so not make it okay to use it, because it's not conspicuous. תלמוד לומר, so therefore you need the pasuk, the verse that said, מן הבהמה, from the cattle, להוציא רובה ונרווה, to exclude those cases of animal. מן הבקר, the Torah said in Leviticus 1, from the herd, להוציא את הנאבה, to exclude the animal that was worshipped. ולא דין ומה אתננו מחיר שציפויין מותרין הנסורין, נאבד שציפויו אסור, לא דין שהוא אסור. או חילוף, or perhaps one can reverse this reason. ומה אתננו מחיר שאין אסורין ציפויין מותרין, נאבד שמותר יהיה ציפויו מותר. כמו שאת, אם כן ביטלת לא תחמוד כסף וזהב עליהם ולקחת לך. Because in Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 25 they said you shall not cover the silver or the gold that is on them nor take it to you. So you have a very lucid reference to coveting of items of worship in addition to idols themselves. So the Gemara said, אני הקיימנו, I established the clause. לא תחמוד כסף וזהב בדבר שאין בו רוח חיים, אבל בדבר שיש בו רוח חיים הואיל ואין מותר, יכול יהיה ציפוי מותר, תלמוד לומר מן הבקר, להוציא את הנאבד. מתקיף לרב חנניה, תם עד מייתי קרא, הלו מייתי קרא ציפוי מותר, הלא מייתי קרא ציפוי מותר, והכתיב יבטם את שמם, כל העשוי לשמם, ההוא לחנות להם שם ודעתה, לבית גל יקרין אותו בית קריה, פני המולך, פני כלב, אין קול, אין קוץ, והיפוך אנא מן הבמה להוציא את הנאבד, מן הבקר להוציא רובה ונרבה. התם מעניינה דקרא, כתיב גבי במה והשקית אין שחובתו בבמה מות יומת, גבי בקר כתיר והאמירו את כבודם בתבנית שור אוכל עשב, מן הצון להוציא את המוקצה ומן הצון להוציא את הנוגח. אמר רבי שמעון, אם נאמר רובה למה נאמר נוגח, ונאמר נוגח למה נאמר רובה, לפי שישנו ברובה מה שאין כן בנוגח, יש ברובה שהרובה עושה אונס כרצון, מה שאין כן בנוגח. יש בנוגח שהנוגח משלם את הכופר, מה שאין כן ברובה. הוא צריך לומר רובה והוא צריך לומר נוגח. והאיתנה מייטל להח, מהאחד, איתניה הרובה והנרבה וכולם הם כקודשים שקדם עובר להקדשן. הוא צריכים קבוע לבדות עליהם, שנאמר כי מושחתם בהם, מומבה, מי תלמודה. חסורי מחסרה והחיקטני. מניין שהן אסורים, תלמוד לומר, כי מושחתם בהם מומבם, ותנא דבר רבי ישמעאל, כל מקום שנאמר השחתה אינו לו דבר ערווה ועבודה זרה, דבר ערווה דכתיב כי ישחית כל בשר, עבודה זרה דכתיב פן דשחיתון ועשיתן לכם פסל תמונת כל סמל, כל שהמום פוסל בהם, דבר ערווה ועבודה זרה פוסלים בהם. ותנא דבר רבי ישמעאל, מן הבהמה, מן הבקר ומן הצאן, מה יידרש בהו, מבעיה פרט לחולה, זקן ומזוהם. ותנא קמא דאפקינהו לה נקראי לרובע ונרבה, חולל זקן ומזוהם מנעלי, נפקא ליה מן הצאן, מן הכבשים ומן העיזים, ולתנא דבר רבי ישמעאל, עורכי דקרא להשתאוי הכי.